Although appearing to be an out-of-place NASA space shuttle, the craft is actually a Soviet space program project called Tichka, and it has been languishing untouched for nearly 30 years. The abandoned shuttle is one of the last remaining remnants of the Buran program, a 20 billion ruble Soviet-Russian initiative to develop reusable spacecraft that was in operation from 1974 to 1993. The story of the Buran shuttle begins at the height of the Cold War, with an initial Soviet plan to develop a secret space plane known as the Spiral Orbiter. The hypermaneuverable craft was envisioned to steer with rotating wings that could fold up in orbit and during re-entry, and 8 thrusters would be used to propel it in space. The orbiter was intended to perform 3 functions from space: reconnaissance using high-resolution cameras, bombing of targets on Earth via orbit-to-surface missiles, and interception of targets in space. Primarily considered an offensive weapon to combat the perceived threat of the American Boeing X-20 Dinosaur, its progress was closely monitored by the Soviet Ministry of Defense. The Spiral project got off the ground in 1962 and was headed by the OKB-155 Design Bureau, the team behind the development of the MIG fighter jet. Over the course of a decade, only modest progress was made on the ambitious aerospace system. 3 progressively complex scale models were made, including one 3,300-pound, 1,500-kilogram half-scale model, but the Spiral Orbiter itself would never be built. Frustrated with the pace of development, the project was shut down in 1978, after the Soviet Union realized it was easier to steal space plane technology than create it on its own. The Spiral design was migrated to the BOR unmanned spacecraft program that continued into the 1980s, while Soviet intelligence turned their attention to NASA's space transportation system. At the time, the United States was pouring enormous resources into the development of its shuttle program, and the Soviet Union felt immense pressure to match the technology. In response, a deeply suspicious Soviet leadership launched the Buran program to develop the technology for themselves, which involved a full-scale effort to steal designs from the US shuttle program. According to investigative journalist Robert Windrum, the theft was surprisingly easy to pull off because NASA's shuttle technology was not classified at the time. Shockingly, Soviet spies were able to request many crucial documents on shuttle research and design directly from the government printing office. Spies also hacked into US government and university computer systems to steal shuttle research documents in what Windrum describes as one of the first ever cases of internet espionage. Early computer programs were used to comb through the thousands of pages of documents to identify designs for everything from propulsion vehicles to heat shield materials. The theft allowed the Soviet Union to save billions of dollars on the development of their own shuttle program, as they didn't have to put their orbiter through all the wind tunnel tests and computer simulations. A report from the US Defense Intelligence Agency concluded that by using US propulsion, computer, materials, and airframe technology and designs, the Soviets were able to produce an orbiter years earlier and at far less cost than doing so independently. Despite stealing much of the technology, the Buran program was still the largest and the most expensive in the history of Soviet space exploration, and at its height employed 150,000 researchers and engineers. Construction of the Soviet shuttles began in 1980, and the first scale model, the BOR-5, completed its first atmospheric testing flight in 1983. Throughout the 80s, it and several other models would subsequently conduct 25 atmospheric test flights to assess the craft's in-flight properties, maneuverability, and aerodynamics. The models were so large they had to be ferried around by the Antonov An-225 Maria, the longest, widest, and heaviest airplane in the world, with 6 turbofan engines. Unlike the US space shuttle program, Buran developed a fully powered test platform with the designation OKGLI. Known as the Buran Aerodynamic Analog, the vehicle was fitted with 4 AL-31 jet engines mounted at the rear that allowed it to take off on its own power rather than having to be dropped from a companion aircraft. By 1988, the program had produced Buran, or the Orbiter K-1, the first operational Soviet shuttle. Though the Buran was largely based on stolen American space shuttle designs, the two had significantly different propulsion devices. The US shuttle relied on rocket boosters and 3 integrated engines for thrust, while the Buran was launched only with a specially modified Energia rocket that detached after liftoff. Buran itself had no main engines, essentially making it a space glider. A final distinction was that the US shuttle required a pilot to fly it on re-entry, while the Buran was theoretically capable of landing on its own using autopilot. On November 15th, the Orbiter K-1 flew its first and only orbital test mission, successfully completing two unmanned orbits in 3 hours and 25 minutes. Buran's autopilot worked far better than expected, landing the craft very near its target while fighting lateral wind speeds up to 38 miles per hour. To this day, the Buran remains the only Soviet reusable spacecraft to be launched into space. Shortly after this first flight, economic problems and rising political tensions in the Soviet Union led to a suspension of the Buran program. After the end of the Cold War and fall of the Soviet Union, the project was officially terminated by Russian President Boris Yeltsin in 1993. The famed orbiter K-1 Buran was stored in a hangar at the Baikonur Cosmodrome, a spaceport in southern Kazakhstan. In 2002, the roof of the hangar housing Buran collapsed due to structural failure in a tragic accident that killed 8 workers and completely destroyed the orbiter. Today, all that remains of the Buran program are 2 partially finished orbiters that had been in development when the project was cancelled and a smattering of space parts and prototypes. One of the orbiters, the Tichka, lies rotting and forgotten at the Baikonur Cosmodrome, while the other, Baikal, collects dust at the Zhukovsky Air Base near Moscow. Though largely forgotten, the Buran leaves behind a legacy of advanced engineering that may have ultimately surpassed NASA's space shuttle. The Kremlin truly thought that the competing US program hid nefarious intent behind its stated scientific and commercial applications, and engineered the Buran to military-grade standards. Even though the Buran had only 1 spaceflight, some engineers and historians believe that, had the Soviet program continued with adequate funding, that it may have built the most advanced and versatile space launch vehicle humanity has ever known.